Hey guys, it's Chris. From villagers being terrorized by hungry pythons to brown snakes trying to join your bowling team, here are 10 stories of deadly snake encounters. Number 10. Wa-Tiba. This story comes from Indonesia in the village known as Sulawesi, where someone was literally swallowed whole by a massive snake, in this case a giant python. The woman in question was 54-year-old Wa-Tiba. She was checking out her vegetable garden when suddenly she vanished from sight. As the villagers looked around, they found her sandal and her machete. As they continued to search, they found a reticulated python, and it had a rather abnormally large belly that clearly had something or someone in it. They killed the snake and then took it to a place where they could film gutting it. And when they did, they were shocked to find Wa-Tiba inside. The python wrapped itself around her, constricting her. She wouldn't be able to breathe, let alone scream. This allowed the snake to easily swallow her whole. One can only imagine the thoughts of the villagers after finding Wa-Tiba like this. This actually happens more than you think, too. Snakes are able to swallow very large prey, especially if the snake itself is as big as this python was. There are multiple documented stories of serpents swallowing goats, cows, alligators, and yes, also people. Number 9. Milo Sutcliffe. Picture this, you're minding your own business in the comfort of your own home, and you look out your window to see an unwanted guest slithering into your backyard. The snake is a major threat to you and your family, so you decide to go and do the rational thing. You kill it. In the case of Milo Sutcliffe, he killed the snake he found with a shovel, decapitating it. In case you're curious, yes, the cut the head off the snake and the body dies line is an accurate one. But there is a twist here, because not unlike certain parts of the human body, if you aren't careful, a certain body part can still react even after being severed from the rest of itself. Kind of like a chicken running around with its head cut off, but in this case, it was a dangerous snake. Thinking he had killed it, he went to pick up the head of the snake, but that turned out to be the worst mistake of his life. The rattlesnake's head still had signs of life, and getting its final revenge, it bit Sutcliffe with everything it had. Now, there is a difference between getting bit by a live snake and a soon-to-be-dead one. A live snake can regulate its venom delivery, and will keep some back, but a headless one, well, obviously it's going to give you whatever it has because it won't be needing it anyway. Sutcliffe was poisoned so badly he needed 26 doses of antivenom, and even spent 5 days in a medically induced coma. Number 8. The Obsession of Bill Hast. There are many people who love to study snakes. They're known as herpetologists. For Bill Hast, he wasn't that, but rather an obsessed collector of snakes from all around the world. And we do mean around the world. He would apparently go to places like South America and Africa and find snakes to add to his weird collection. He eventually collected so many of them that he owned his own serpentarium, where he would not only showcase his wide variety of snakes, he would drain them of their venom for those that paid him to do so. This is where several twists come in, because you might think, there's no way he didn't get bit by those snakes, right? Well, you're correct. In fact, he was bit by snakes over 170 times, and many of them were venomous snakes. So how did he survive? Well, apparently he was bitten so much that he had an immunity to some of the snake venom. Believe it. In fact, he would help this along by willingly injecting himself with the venom so his body could get used to it. To everyone's shock and amazement, he lived to be 100 years old. Number 7. Teen versus inland taipan. In terms of pure venom, the deadliest snake on the planet is the inland taipan. This snake has a kind of toxin that is perfect for killing warm-bodied beings, you know, like us humans. In 2012, near Sydney, Australia, there was a very unlucky teenager who was bitten by the taipan and was able to survive, which is actually kind of a miracle. One bite from this snake in almost all instances will kill you in less than an hour. So how did this young lad survive a bite from this deadly creature? Well, fortunately for him, he was very close to the hospital when he was bitten, so they were able to give him the life-saving antidote. But wait, there is another twist here. Because the inland taipan should not be found in Sydney. They're usually found in areas very far away from there, in regard to Australia at least, and thus it's believed that this one was kept as a pet and then let loose. What kind of maniac keeps an inland taipan as a pet? Well, your guess is as good as ours. Number 6. An Evening with the Mambas. Mess with cobras, rattlesnakes, or even pythons and you might just get away with it. But never, ever mess with a black mamba. Black mambas can grow up to 14 feet in length, and they can move at a high speed of 12.5 miles per hour. Their venom can and will kill you in 10 minutes flat. If you live in Black Mamba territory, make sure your home is an anti-snake fortress, because it's better to be safe than sorry. Chiposat Adomo from Kenya learned about Black Mambas the hard way. She was walking home from a party in her hilly village of Chirangan, in Kenya's West Pokot County, close to the Ugandan border. It was dark, and suddenly a 6.5-foot Black Mamba coiled around her foot and bit her 3 times. What terrified her even more was the presence of 2 more Black Mambas who thought of approaching Adomo as if barging into an uninvited dinner. Luckily, help appeared out of nowhere in the crazy form of a man with a machete, taking out the duo before they could join in on the fun. The 3rd Black Mamba had already fled away. Adomo began losing her vision and soon started fainting. The man managed to get her to the hospital in the nick of time, where she was given antivenom. Thankfully, she survived, but I can't say the same for almost 30,000 people who die in Kenya from snake bites every single year. Number 5. Lorraine Johnson. Lorraine Johnson was hiking between Los Angeles and the Santa Monica Mountains when all of a sudden, a snake camouflaged in the brush around her feet slithered out and bit her. She actually noticed the snake a split second before, but it was too late to try and avoid it. And even worse, it was a venomous rattlesnake. Within seconds, I started feeling the effects, blurred vision, jelly-like legs, and a horrifying sense of panic, wrote Lorraine, recounting her horrific ordeal for Backpacker magazine. While it wasn't her fault she got bit, she absolutely picked the wrong time to go into that area. The spot was known for being infested with rattlesnakes. She went on this hike after work, which was apparently the time of day when the snakes liked to bask in the evening light and feel the cool temperature. She was almost asking for it. And it was quite the ordeal after getting bit. The snake that bit me injected a standard-issue hemotoxin, along with a rare and more powerful neurotoxin that quickly interfered with my brain's signals to my respiratory system, she says. I didn't know it at the time, but I had to get help fast if I was going to survive. Thankfully, she did, but not without a bit of luck on her side. She was able to flag down some drivers who took her to a nearby hospital so she could start the healing process. Within an hour of my bite, the doctors administered the first of 116 vials of antivenom that would ultimately save my life, the victim recalled. By her own admission, if she had been deeper into her hike, she likely would have died, as she wouldn't have gotten to the hospital in time. Number 4. Akbar Salubiro. This next story might sound familiar, as it's very similar to what happened to Watiba. It was a typical day in his village for Akbar Salubiro from Indonesia when he set off to his fields for a harvest. But when his family found him missing for an unusual length of time, they decided to investigate. They gathered a search party and ventured out into the fields where they came upon his shed. And what they saw inside shocked them to their core. Slithering around on the floor was a massive reticulated python at least 23 feet in length. There was also a bulge in the python's belly that suggested it had just had its meal for the day, and a pretty large meal at that. Snakes like this swallow their food whole and digest it over the next few days as the food breaks down in their stomachs. Fearing that it could be Akbar, the villagers caught the python and split it open. It was indeed their missing friend. The python had crushed him to putty and was in the process of digesting him before the villagers discovered what the hungry serpent had done. We can only assume the snake had been starving, and it turned out Akbar was an easy meal. Number 3. Janice Taylor. Janice Taylor is sadly another victim of snake bites, but unlike some of the ones previously detailed, hers was quite the ordeal in terms of how she got bit and how that bite affected her. You see, she was not bit in the usual way. Taylor was an avid bowler, and one night she was at the bowling club and she suddenly felt something on her foot. At the time, she thought she'd been bitten by a spider. She shook it off and continued to bowl. Except she was not bitten by a spider, but a snake, whose venom went through her body and made her collapse face first on the floor. Ouch! Later on, it was revealed that she had gotten bitten by a brown snake, which is the 2nd most venomous snake in the world by certain people's metrics. This would explain why she fell to the ground so quickly after being bit. What was a snake doing at the bowling alley, though? I feel like there's a punchline to this one somewhere. The venom of the brown snake made her face not just swell, but start to bleed. The doctors didn't think she had a very good chance to survive. Thankfully, she did, though. And after that experience, she became an advocate for having that bowling club and other surrounding stores to put up warning signs about snakes in the area, so that others won't have to fear getting bit like she was. Number 2. The zoo's python. Hearing that there is a snake at a zoo is not concerning at all. Zoos are a great place to learn about snakes and see them up close and personal in ways that you can't and shouldn't do in the natural world. The catch, though, is that the zookeepers technically can get even closer to these snakes, and it usually ends terribly for them if they're dumb enough to try. For reasons unknown to man and science, employee Eric Arrieta was going past the enclosure of a Burmese python and felt the need to open up its cage in order to get closer to it. Again, why would he feel such an urge is kind of beyond us, but it was 100% against the rules to do such a thing. And he did it in the middle of the night, so there was no one around to help him should something go wrong. And naturally, something went wrong. And the next morning, his co-workers arrived at the zoo to find the python fully wrapped around Eric's body, attempting to eat him whole, starting with its head, which we're pretty sure already didn't have a brain in it. The young man underestimated the animal's instincts, said Javier Hernandez, director general of the Parque del Este Zoo. And yeah, that is one way of putting it. Number 1. Snake in the toilet. There are a lot of urban myths about snakes, and some of them are just plain sad. But one of them that seems like a myth but actually isn't is that some snakes come up through toilets for a very surprising and sometimes very painful visit while you're doing your business. For example, there was a man in Thailand who went to use the toilet, sat down to, you know, do what you do, and then got bitten by a python in his family jewels. He apparently bled profusely and had to be taken to the hospital. End of story? Well, not so much. One of the people in the rescue party for this man noted that in Thailand, this happens quite often, which is honestly rather horrifying. The sad thing here is that it's not hard to see how this could happen. The snake gets into a pipe, and it follows the pipe up until it reaches an opening, which just so happens to be the toilet. This has happened more than once in countries all over the world. There were even cases of this in 2021 in places like Austria. So if you're using a bathroom toilet and you're not familiar with it, do be careful and check out what you're sitting on and what's in it before doing your business. Thanks for watching. What do you think of these stories of people getting attacked, bitten, and even eaten by snakes? Have you ever been bitten by a snake before, or do you know someone who has? Can you believe the events that befell some of these people? Which story is the most horrifying to you? Let us know in the comments section down below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.